Yeah, I mean, that's basically what happened. I think we didn't play as aggressive as we did before. All the things that were working for us, you know, we were a little bit passive on the offensive and defensive end.
Why does that happen?
Well, I mean, sometimes, you know, I have no idea. You know, sometimes it just happens. And, you know, it's early in the season. We live and we learn. So we're going to have to make sure that we recognize it earlier next time and make sure that if we do come out playing a little timid, we, you know, turn the defense up, get a little bit more aggressive.
Chris, no surprise, but obviously Duncan was huge for them.
Mm-hmm.
Can you talk about his play today and how you matched up against him?
Well, I mean, Tim Duncan, he's a, you know, a superstar in this league, and, you know, he's pretty much going to get hit sometimes, and, you know, you have to live with that. But, I mean, other guys for them shot high percentages, and, you know, sometimes it just can't happen.
Some of Duncan's teammates thought maybe a little quicker this year. Did you find that?
I mean, he's always been the same to me. I'm not really measuring the guy's quickness or how fast he is. I'm just, you know, just notice how his low post play is, and it's still the same.
One of the bright spots is you kept him obviously off the boards, but you couldn't keep Brent Berry from connecting from the 3-point line.
Well, yeah, you know, sometimes, you know, guys on the bench come in hot. And, you know, we can't give up wide open looks like that. He just got a couple wide open looks, and then, you know, next thing you know, he's hitting everything. So, you know, next time we're just going to have to rotate a little bit better on defense, make sure that we make him make plays instead of just stepping into a wide open shot and knocking it down, because that's what he likes to do.
Do you feel there's, looking back, like they really made you work today? Like you didn't get a lot of easy looks at the basket,
yeah.
And the stuff that went down for you was almost exclusively tough shots.
Well, yeah, that's what San Antonio does. And, you know, I expected that. You know, I kind of was settling for jump shots early. But, you know, after I got aggressive, you know, I got to the rim. I got a lot of easy buckets. Well, they weren't easy, but, you know, I got to the rim. I got some points in the paint. And, you know, I just wish I could have started out the game like that. But, you know, can't take it back. But, you know, they're a good defensive team. They clog up that lane. They make teams shoot jump shots. And, you know, I just had to pick my aggression up a little later in the game.
Did you look at something like your free throw attempts and wish you maybe could have got to the line a little bit more?
Well, yeah, I wish I could have got to the line a lot more, you know, in the past two games. But, you know, it hasn't happened for me yet. I just have to, you know, measure guys out. You know, as the season goes on, I'll get a little bit. I'll continue to wear guys down. That's when I'll be able to get to the free throw line.
You got to the line a ton last year, right?
Like, mm-hmm.
And is it this style is not really conducive to getting you those opportunities where you get guys off the dribble?
Well, I think so. After a while, you know, we just have to keep wearing teams down. Yeah. You know, they did a good job of keeping fresh bodies in. And like I say, we weren't being aggressive, you know. We had running opportunities, but we kind of walked it up and down the floor. Yeah. You know, we should have just kept running. And it's tough because, you know, when you're running sometimes and they stay with you, you just have to stay committed to it to wear them down.
Yeah.